Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. In this video I will show you how you can use PowerAutomate to list all the folders from a SharePoint Online library. First I've prepared a library with some folders, subfolders and files, and my goal is to list up only the folders from this library. So here we see we have some folders and subfolders, and here are some documents in it too. I have found a few solutions to this in some help forums. Either they're using the REST API or simply get all the items from the library and then filter that array. But what if I told you that there is a much simpler way? So let's go to PowerAutomate and create a new flow. So we select here, create new flow, and it doesn't really matter. We just use an instant flow. We can skip this. So, okay, good. So we'll add a new step here. We go to SharePoint and then we use the get files properties only. We use the site address, the library, and then we go to advanced options and put in here the filter query FSObjective equals 1. And then we'll add a new step. We go here to data operation and then the select action. We want the values of the get files property. So then we say your name. So we also had the, oops, not here. We want this over here. And then we'll make a path. Let's say full path. And then we go to test manually. Run flow, done. So what we get here, you know, it's kind of messy. It's hard to read it. So that's why I made the select here. It's a little bit easier what we get here. And we really see that it only selected the folders. And if I want to reverse this, I can go here to edit. Get files property and it's not equal 1. So we make that test again. We can do it manually. So run flow, done. And now we only get the files and not the folders. So this is how you can separate those two. You might ask yourself now, how did I come up with this? Because if we go back here, FSObjective is actually not a property that you get from this action. So how did I get that? So if you have access to your SharePoint site via the PowerShell, you can list the doc. You can list all the items from this library via PMP. And if you look at the item on the field values, you will see that here we have this field FSObjective, and that's what you can access on the OData filter query. And that's basically it. I hope you found this video helpful. And if you have any further questions or other topics I could look into, then write me a comment. Thank you for watching and I wish you a great day.